So it's all exciting. You're starting a new course at college. You're training to be an electrician. And that means you rush home and tell your grown-ups you need some tools. Well, that's sort of true and not true at the same time. There will be certain tools that make your life considerably easier when you're at college, especially in that first 10 to 12 weeks, which leads us up to Christmas. I know not everybody celebrates it, but it is a national holiday and gives you an opportunity then to work out whether you really enjoy the course and add to the tools that are in your collection. When I say collection, it means you've got to start off with some tools to make your life easier. And in this video, I want to try and show you four tools that will make that first 10 to 12 weeks easier. And if you've got any tools that you think would be beneficial, please leave them in the comments below. Nice, easy one to start off with. First of all, it's a tape measure. Okay, so this for me would not be substantial enough to be used within the electrical workshop. You can already see it's starting to wilt, and it is only 3 meters in length. Okay, it's likely you'll be working on boards to start with, so a 3 meter tape would be okay. As you move into cubicles, you're gonna need a longer tape measure. For me, no, not to this one, but it's a very inexpensive tool. You can see I've had mine branded with my own initial on there, so the G for GSH Electrical. So this tape measure here, we can see is a considerably wider for the tape itself, and this is a lot more substantial and is 5 meters in length. Okay, so that would be the first tool that I would look to add before I get too far into my course. It's inexpensive. Having a decent tape measure will make your life easier, because often at college, the tape measures are wrecked and therefore make it considerably more difficult to measure between boxes or height of boxes. So a simple one to start off with. I recommend that you get yourself a tape measure. Next up is one of the many screwdrivers you're going to come across during your study program, but this one here is a Pozi number 2. Okay, so it's a Pozi 2 screwdriver, and this would be the one that you're going to be using alongside your Pozi headed screws in order to screw in your electrical accessories. It's unlikely you'll be using that length. At college, you might be using something a little bit shorter in screw length as well. But we can see that when we nestle those two in together, having a decent Pozi 2 screwdriver will make your life considerably easier when you're screwing your boxes to the wall or to a wooden board, because the ones at college will have been used for years and years and years, start to wear and they slip. And you think, oh, it's me, I can't get the screws in, I'm not strong enough. It's a technique I haven't got. It's more often than not because you haven't got a decent screwdriver. You notice this one is uninsulated for its shaft, so you don't need a fully insulated screwdriver when you're looking at a Pozi 2 screwdriver. This one here I've had for years and years and years and is a fantastic screwdriver. It's worth perhaps spending a fraction more on this screwdriver maybe than getting one in a shopping center or somewhere like an Asda, where you pick up a Pozi 2 screwdriver that's quite inexpensive. You're going to find that's going to wear really quickly as well. So maybe a little bit more money spent on your Pozi 2 screwdriver than perhaps your tape measure. And I actually got that one for free as well. So they're your first two tools that I think will make your life considerably easier when at college. Measuring out and screwing down. The next one, I'm torn between two tools, so I'm going to bring them both in. So I'm torn between needing a set of side cutters, which are these, or a set of pliers, which are these. So I'm torn between the two. So why am I torn between the two is because they can't quite do both the same jobs. They do a lot of jobs that are similar. So of course they've got a cutting action. So both of them have got a cutting blade so you can cut cable. We're likely to be using the cables on the table in front of me here, twin and CPC or flex in those early weeks. So of course they can cut, but this one here can't double the cables over. So your side cutters can't double the terminations over. And at my college, I expected my learners to double over all their ends into things like light switches. Whereas obviously here, we've got the ability to cut and double over, but we can't split the cable. So the easiest thing to do is give a demonstration. If I'm working with flexes in the early weeks, maybe I'm making off a plug top, I can use my side cutters to perhaps nibble round the actual flex. If I wasn't using a knife, I used to teach my learners to use a knife. You can nibble round and you can start that process of breaking away this PVC outer sheath. And as I go around there, and then perhaps I can just pull that away. You can see it's starting to break through in order to break that out. And I've then exposed my conductors there for that one. Okay, so that's using a pair of side cutters. And of course, once I've finished and cut, get rid of the cable and we can go again. So that would be side cutters being used. I can also use my side cutters when working with twin and CPC cables when I want to split straight down the center of them. So if I go here, I can snip down there. And I've got the ability then to look at trying to part the conductors and obviously split them so we can run it down. Once we've run it down, I like to use, again, you know me, Gary's not going to use a knife in this demonstration, electrician's knife, but I like to run a knife around here to make it nice and neat. But at some colleges, they would take their side cutters or pliers, and they would just tidy the ends up, obviously using the actual side cutters themselves. It does take a little bit of work in order to make them reasonably neat. So if I go again here, maybe I can just tidy that up a little bit better. And then we've got our cables ready for terminating. Now, it could be that you're using side cutters again. So side cutters are winning at the minute, you're thinking. You must get yourself a set of side cutters. So I can cut my cables, and if I'm really careful, I can nip and I can just pull the conductor's insulation off to expose the copper conductors. But now I'm in the, I can't double them over. At my college, I would want these doubling over. So again, I could have used my pliers. I could have cut the cable with my pliers. I can remove the outside PVC with my pliers. But now what I can do with a pair of pliers is I can take the ends and I can actually double those over, depending on what I'm going into, whether I'm going into a light switch or a socket, which I can't do with my side cutters. So I'm torn there. I'm going to say you need both. You need both a pair of side cutters and a pair of pliers. Do not go all brand in. I would suggest you use unbranded tools or relatively inexpensive tools for these four that you need for a number of reasons. You might not like the course and get to Christmas and say, I'm quitting. And if your grown-ups at home have spent several hundred pounds on actual tools, then of course that's a waste. But what else could happen? You notice these have all got blue tape on them. I've tried to brand these up, so if I left them somewhere, I'd say to them, I've left my Pozi drive screwdriver behind, it's got blue tape on it. I know you can peel the tape off. But these here, if I did lose them at college or somebody happened to pick them up by accident, take them home themselves, it's an inexpensive tool I've lost and I've not gone for a branded tool. So they're the four tools that I think are going to help you along your way in those first 10 to 12 weeks before we get to the Christmas break. And I would go with a decent 5 meter tape measure, a Pozi number 2 screwdriver that doesn't have to be insulated. I think we're going to have to go with both side cutters and pliers in order to make our life a lot easier. However, if there's a tool you think that would make an electrician's training life easier, somebody maybe on a full-time course that hasn't got a toolkit through work, please leave it in the comments below and we'll see what other tools that maybe we can add to another video. And if you're thinking about twin and CPC or twin and earth cable and want to learn how to clip it like a pro, check out the video on screen just there.